What? There's a test? No one told me there'd be a test. Seconds to pick your answer. Oh no. Identify this large-scale programming thing. ENIAC. What British built its own digital computer in E. Well, I know there's a BBC computer. I'll say B. Oh yeah, that's not the BBC computer. Even close. Okay, I would never get. I never knew what the name of this one was. Which 19th century British mansion estate was top secret home of British World War II codebreakers and the famous Colossus computer? Oh, I thought these were going to be computer questions. I guess they are sort of. British Mansion. British Mansion. I'm gonna go with E, Spencer Families. This sounds like I should know who this is. Nope, never heard of it. Henry Wine, what's she doing? What's she doing? It's like a circuit board. Each of these is an integrated circuit. Capable of storing. Not much. Anyway, she's replacing the thing with she's gonna she's these are like the programming things. She's putting the programs in there. It's like the old Heathkit sets in the 70s and you snap them together like Legos and then you put wires and stuff on them. Here you didn't have to use the wires because the wires were already. The breadboard basically is back here thing. This is IBM computer had about SMS cards. I don't know, like a logic circuit thing, something. Printed circuit boards, pluggable. Yeah, that's what it is. That's what I'm right. I'm right. I didn't know what this I didn't know what to call these things, but that's this it's these things. Logic boards. That thing she's holding in her hand. That thing she's holding in her hand used to be this big on one board with a bunch of test tubes. Okay, Remington Rand. Oh, the UNIVAC produced this unique giant computer for Lawrence Livermore. What was it called? What was it called? 1960? The UNIVAC. UNIVAC 1? What was it called? I always called it the UNIVAC. It had a name? What were they doing in Lawrence Livermore? What were they doing there? It wasn't the census, was it? But what were they doing? Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory. They were... It was for a fission reactor? But I don't know what it's called. I don't know what it was called. What was it called? Oh, I see. Here it is. It was LARC. Okay. Fine. Identify the computer shown in this film clip. Well, raise the camera up so I can see the number. The model number on the top. It doesn't look like an IBM. IBM wouldn't let you do this kind of stuff. Oh, what brand computer is this? Deck. I'm going to say it's a deck. Uh-oh, I'm wrong. These monitor, these CRTs are way old. This must be like 1960. What's the size? This thing's as big as a deck. Deck 10, but it could be, this could be a Sperry system. Control Data Corporation. Okay. They made orange computers. Okay. I mean, technically, these are just tape drives. Best known for its radio, television, and music technology, what company produced this? 3301 real-time computer in 1963. RCA? Philips? Dun, dun, dun. Did RCA make anything that big? I know they had home computers. Let's see. What's another radio, television, and music technology that made big ass mainframes? Man, these are tough. Not the Sony. I don't think Sony was making mainframes. Radio, television, and music technology. Me and my hiccups. I'm gonna say it's a Philips. Oh, it said RCA. I should have gone with my first guess. It said RCA on the screen there. Go back. Right here, RCA. Okay, it's the RCA. RCA with Philips tubes. Now, I'm sure it had transistors instead of tubes in there. Which one is that? I can't read. Which one is... Oh, it's just personal computer. 1981. She died recently. She died like 2 weeks ago. Interesting. She was an anchor woman back in the day. She was like one of the first anchor women back in the 60s. 1981. Nailed it. In 1982, the Rainbow Desktop PC was released by what company? The NEC. NEC. Do-do-do. Oh, no, I take it back. DEC. D-E-C. 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 I always get DEC and NEC mixed together. But DEC was like 15 years before NEC. Yeah, this is what you wrote Star Trek games on. I don't know what she's doing, but I was doing Star Trek games. The Osborne, what about it? Was developed and released by Adam Osborne in what year? 1970. I'm gonna say 1979. But heck, they were still selling those things until. Yeah, 1979. The transluggable computer. That Osborne. I was thinking of the heavier one. It had a dark gray square case. This is more bulging out on the side. Had the same screen though. I'm thinking of the Osborne one. I don't know what model of Osborne this one is. This is more like around the time of K-Pro and Compaq transluggable. Oh, speaking of transluggables, this one looks like it says Compaq right there. It says Compaq right here. And this one looks like a later model of the transluggable Compaq. That looks familiar. What model is this? Focus, enhance, please. Name at least two tech components seen in this film clip. Tech components? Tech components. Well, you got dual floppy drives here, and then you have a CRT terminal. Teletype screen. Not amber, but the other color. Maybe the computer is inside this thing as well as the floppy drives. Sometimes the computer is inside this thing. Could this be just the terminal, or is this the computer and terminal? Like in Fallout 3? Or is this the computer? The computer. There's no lights or anything in front of this. But that still doesn't mean it's not a computer. Tell me what I'm looking at. I see a phone. Is that with an acoustic coupler? She's doing some sort of dictation or something. She's got her nice amplifier here. She can listen to some sweet tunes. Up, there it is, the acoustic coupler. How many did I name? Three so far? Four? I've named four so far. But I just see three things. She has to call the Pentagon or the CIA, upload what she's typed to them. What does that say? What does that say? I don't think I had this brand at the school I was at. When we would dial up weather stations. I don't know why we would do this. We would dial up weather stations like in Alaska and then connect. And we're in panic mode because we're dialing long distance, you know. And then we plug our phone into this thing here and we log in on some weather thing / the Russians are coming, you know, one of those kind of stations. Ice Station Zebra, you know, that kind of thing. Oh, they chopped it. They chopped it. They didn't show her even plugging it in. They just chopped. So we got a Wang computer, a disk drive unit, a phone, a modem, acoustic coupler. Okay. The modem is inside the acoustic coupler. So, am I supposed to name at least two? What was I supposed to do here? Name at least two? At least two, okay. Phone unit, disk drive unit, wing. Yeah. Oh, it just says wing right here. Duh. I should have recognized the logo. Again, programming. What was I programming on this thing? Colossus, the Forbin project, when the thing's launching the nukes. We would write programs that would say, please log in. And you log in, it says, welcome, Dr. Forbin, you know, that kind of thing. And then we say, here are the nuke silos that are armed and ready for launch. And you have to try to convince the robot to not launch the nukes. And it would list out the cities and countries that are going to be nuked. And you're like, no, I will not have green eggs and ham. And you're trying to convince the computer to not launch the nukes. Your basic, what's that called? You're using some sort of, what is it called? Not a debate. You're using, what is it called? Like a logic kind of a thing? You know, like a... You know, something is tiny. Okay, like a... What's something small that I have? Do I have something small? I don't have anything small. I don't own anything small, really. Okay, so let's say you have oh, a piece of rice. If I have rice, it's in the cupboard. So a grain of rice is small. An ant is small. Therefore, an ant is a grain of rice. So you're trying to use logic like that with the computer. The computer's trying to go against your argument. And I know this is weird stuff for 10th grade, but anyway, it is what it is. As Eric July would say, it is what it is. It is. Hang on. What number? I want to see what number she dialed. What number did she dial? What number did she dial? We should all call that number right now. Seven. Seven, two, one, five, one. Okay. Man, everyone dial that number. Everyone dial that number and see what you get. You can tell it's legit because she didn't dial 555. Oh, I wasn't keeping track of how many. Nice try. I think I got nice try. Well, that was neat.